modern cities with its neons, glass frontage, and deluge of traffic springs from the engineering prowess of city dwellers. With an insatiable hunger for infrastructure, these cities guzzle cement and steel, and the result is dusty air and choked roads. The problems of our times might be huge, but young minds are at work to solve these problems.
Certain parts of the building that generate heat are air conditioned, although, and for the wood.
Speaking about heat, the natives have their own way of cooling themselves, and they too are planning to build a school. Far from the newfound intelligence of cities, their vision is guided by traditional wisdom. From the land of rolling hills and thick forests, these men who belong to tribes such as Jainu Kurubas, Kadu Kurubas, Haki Pikis are about to gift a bamboo school to their children. From your jungles of Kodagu and Mysore districts of Karnataka have been protected as sacred groves by these Adivasis. The resounding similarity between the culture of these tribals and natural wonders speaks volumes about their harmonious life. Here is a quick look at the Forest Rights Act. To recognize the forest rights and occupation by natives and provide a framework for implementation of welfare measures. Ever since the recognition of Forest Rights Act 2006 came to fore, the District Administration of Mysore has played a pivotal role in seamlessly integrating the interests of natives with other laws governing the protection of forests and its biodiversity. Although this harmonization is easier said than done, the Honorable DC of the city of Mysore has taken up this challenge with great elan. There can be no better way of explaining this than in her own words.
So under various Government of India and Government of Karnataka projects, we are constructing a lot of Anganwadis throughout the state. But in this case, as you know, that Mysore has a major population of tribal people who are still living in tribal hadis, which are deep inside the forest reserve areas. So when we visited there, we realized that forest acts do not permit any kind of concrete activities to be taken place there. At the same time, the Anganwadis were in a very pathetic situation, because even it used to rain, Anganwadis used to leak, the food products were not in good condition, there was no scientific storage mechanism. mechanism. Children were suffering. Anganwadi worker was wasting major half of her time in repairing these mud Anganwadis. So then we realized that if not concrete, there has to be an alternative so that we can give these children a good infrastructure which they deserve. Because as it is in all the human development indices, these tribal people fall far behind. So if we can make the foundation itself strong, then we can go a long way in improving these indices. We cannot have a massive concrete construction work in the forest habitat because it will be spoiling the ecosystem also. So with that point in view, we had to maximize on what all the locally available resources as well as environment friendly resources. Like in our olden houses, lime and mortar and mud were the main ingredients which have gradually come down in usage. So same, we went back in tradition. As you know that Mysore is a heritage city, all of our old palaces also same mud and mortar structures are present. With that view in mind, we explored the other alternatives. In this regard, we discussed with NIE, with our Nirmithi Kendra, and then they jointly they came up with an idea of using bamboo as an alternative. Now, as we all know that bamboo is a raw material which is easily available in these forest areas. So that raw material was also available. We could easily train the tribal people also in, you know, cutting it and constructing these Anganwadis. So it was kind of a win-win situation for all of them there.
It won't be surprising if one were to call bamboo as a wonder grass. There is an old saying in Sanskrit, Vajradapi Katorani, Mruduni Kusumadapi, Lokottaranam Chetamsi, Kohi Vigyatum Arhati, which when translated means that a noble person is as strong as a diamond, yet remains tender like a flower. Bamboo is indeed a noble grass. It can beat steel in its tensile strength and can produce the most soothing music. The word bamboo has its origin in Kannada, so it is not surprising that an eco-sensitive architect like Bala and Sham, an expert in the field of sustainable technologies, want to breathe a fresh lease of life into bamboo-based eco-sensitive constructions, especially in tribal hardies.
We have some requirement for this tribal school. Basically, we need some play area with innovative toys. Then we need a place where some 20 to 30 children can sit and learn. We also want a good kitchen where we can adopt some fuel efficient cook stoves for cooking. And a toilet is a must. You know, tribals are not used to toilet and we have to inculcate this toilet. And a solar lighting for children to study in the evening. These are some of the basic requirements. Apart from that, if you can beautify it, give an essence of nature touch to this, it will be good. So what do you say about it?
No, I think we can do a wonderful job there, in the sense we will identify the bamboo clump locally, harvest it, and then treat it in situ itself.
Okay.
And engage the local population in the treatment and the construction as well. And I can show you the entire design. I'll sketch it out for you.
Yeah.
We will have simple structure with, let us say, not more than 4 feet span. So the structurally, it will be as simple as possible.
Bamboo.
The bamboo structures.
Yeah, you know, the DC in herself has initiated the use of bamboo and the tribal development board also for it. I think we can bring a change and make the entire school a sustainable green building. What do you say?
Good.
Yeah, let's do it.
Nice.
Being one of the fastest growing plants in the world, Growing at the rate of 3 feet every day, bamboo beats all conventional timber in terms of its growth. Traditional eco-sensitive methods have always been preferred, even while harvesting a huge clump of bamboo such as this. The clump is chopped at the bottom, while it is secured by a long rope at the top. Pulling this bamboo definitely requires more men and their muscle. And then they're carefully shaped. Pole after pole, all of them go into this path. This way, we can secure them from borers. The inescapable detail with which the machete is sharpened will miss no one's eyes. After being submerged for nearly 20 days, the poles are ready for donning a new role. From a bamboo shoot to a structural grid, the transformation is unmistakable. The sliced bamboo poles or shingles form the building blocks of the structure quite literally. This carefully orchestrated dance might look like a child's play, but mixing mud is serious business. Some more days will go before the school takes its final shape. But
ಇದು ಈ ಹೊಸ ಯೋಜನೆ ಇದು ಇದು ನಿಮ್ದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ನೀವು ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಇದನ್ನ ಅಚ್ಚುಕಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕಾಪಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿನೂ ನಿಮ್ದಿದೆ. ಏನೋ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ತಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾನೆ.